Even in an era defined by extreme hairdos, a flock of seagulls were a cut above the rest. I walk along the avenue. I
never thought I'd meet a girl like you. Love that song. And I really... Yeah, Flock of Seagulls was one of my favourites.
Led by keyboardist and singer Mike Score, the Liverpool quartet created a stir overseas with their signature hairstyle.
I designed this haircut that was like how I'd like to look if I was a spaceman, and then I started to work on it because I used to be a hairdresser.
A lot of people came to see us just to see the hair, so it served its purpose, and you're talking to me now really because I had a crazy haircut.
The band's new romantic meets sci-fi look and space-age video theatrics seemed tailor-made for the new era in music. 1982's Iran was one of the first videos to capitalize on the early success of MTV.
MTV said, if you've got something, we will play it every hour. They were desperate for videos. We were desperate for exposure.
The constant video play helped the single climb into the US top 10, and the pompadoured popsters won a spot opening for The Police. In 1983, they even bagged a Best Rock Instrumental Grammy for their track DNA, but as quickly as a flock of seagulls had risen on the scene, they fell victim to changing tastes. The group's follow-up albums, 1983's Listen and 1984's The Story of a Young Heart, had little chart success, and the band officially retired their hairspray in 1986.
I think partly what happened was that we took off so quickly that we got thrown in the deep end, and we could only swim for so long without like mega help.
Time passes and hairstyles come and go, but the group's infamous do's live on.
You, flock of seagulls, you know why we're here?
Pulp Fiction was the first, and I think it kind of set a trend. I love it. I did a hairdo, which I thought was cool, and 20-odd years later, the world is still talking about it.
Now based in Florida with his wife Tara, lead singer Mike Score is still riding the 80s wave with his new lineup of The Flock. They released an album in 1996 and are busy playing the club circuit.
This band, given the chance, could emulate or even better what the original band did.
Ali Score, the group's original drummer, now works for a computer company in North Carolina. Guitarist Paul Reynolds stayed in the UK and plays with a jazz band, while bassist Frank Maudsley returned to Liverpool to open a sweet shop. Though his haircut may be more memorable than his music, Mike Score is content with his time at the top and confident that there are more hits to come.
I just think if you're good enough, the chance is going to come again.